As flowers and trees start to bloom, there are some that are not wanted and considered invasive.
Yeah, and there's an effort to chop certain ones down. Fox 2's Zara Barker tells us about a buyback program to help get rid of Kellery pear trees. Zara.
Hey, Vic, Mandy. Well, you've probably seen dozens, if not maybe hundreds of these trees all over the St. Louis metro area. They're really pretty. They're one of the first to start to bloom. But experts say they're actually invasive and they want them gone. Part of the reason is too because their limbs are really weak and they don't really stand up to harsh Missouri weather. If you've seen these trees, you've probably smelled them too.
Somebody just recently told me that it smells like an electrical fire or like some sort of chemical burning.
They just smell really bad. Like they're pollinated by flies primarily, which are attracted to like rotting meat.
While they're pretty in bloom, it's not just the smell some don't like, but they're actually considered invasive.
A Kellery pear is a beautiful tree. 20 years ago, we were encouraging people to plant them.
Since then, trees in the Kellery pear family have been able to cross-pollinate. They sprout and take over areas they're not wanted. This video from Bomarito Automotive Group Skyfox shows invasive pear trees along highway corridors.
All of those new trees that are sprouting up are trees that are taking away from the landscape where a native tree could be growing. So they're out competing for the natural habitat.
The Missouri Invasive Plant Task Force is partnering with Forest Relief and Biodiverse City St. Louis for a Kellery pear buyback on April 20th from 3 to 7 p.m.
We're basically giving you a free tree if you cut down your invasive pear tree in your landscape.
You can sign up, cut down your Kellery pear tree, and send in at least one picture.
We're asking that people submit photos of their tree that's cut down as like evidence, so you don't have to bring a whole tree in. We'll just trust your photo. And in exchange, we will give them a free, native, non-invasive, ecologically beneficial tree.
You'll reserve a time slot to pick up a free tree at Forest Relief Community Gardens Nursery to replace the invasive tree.
People don't realize the impact of the one tree that they have in their yard and how that can be detrimental to a whole forest of oaks and hickories, for example.
And if you'd like to learn more and possibly register for this event and also learn how to properly cut down one of these trees so that they don't grow back and resprout, we have all of that information and links up on our website, fox2now.com. Live from Maryland Heights, Zara Barker, Fox 2 News.